Hello, all you Ham Radio Now viewers. I wanted to make a full-blown episode before I got on the road to Austin, but I am out of time. Should I make this an episode? It's going to be quick. Sure, why not? I need to keep the count up. Ham Radio Now, episode 162. Getting on the road to Austin. Like I say, I wanted to make a full-blown episode. What I was going to do is show all the radio programming and preparation that I am hopefully still going to be able to do. It just takes so much longer if I do it as a TV show. I'm out of time. It's Thursday morning. I am going to depart tomorrow afternoon, Friday afternoon, stop in the Charlotte area for the Shelby Hamfest. And then Sunday, get on the road in earnest. And I will, at least the plan is to mount the camera in the car and show ham radio operating and stuff like that. And maybe if I've got time, I'll squeeze in the radio programming and things. It's extensive, and I think it's interesting. I make some useful programming. I've got an interview that I'm hoping to be able to do at the Shelby Hamfest that also should be interesting. And I'm not planning on real long, hard travel days, so I might have a couple hours in the hotel to put something together and try to edit and get online as I'm going down the road, in addition to the on-the-road stuff. We'll see. I get very ambitious. I have discovered something about myself. I am more of an optimist than I thought I was, and not in a very good way. I look at my Google Calendar. I do all my scheduling on Google Calendar now. It's very, very convenient. They can know everything about me. That's okay. I don't have any secrets. And this summer has been jam-packed ever since Field Day. Every day, a solid block of stuff in the calendar showing work, which is why you haven't seen very many Ham Radio Now episodes. And then a week will come along, and I'll look at it on Sunday, and the week coming up will just be empty. And I'll think, wow, I'm going to get a lot done. A lot of Ham Radio Now editing, a lot of other personal projects and stuff. And things keep filling that week in, either business or stuff to do, whatever projects. And the things that I expected to be able to do day by day, can't get to them. I get stuff done, obviously, with 162 episodes. Some Ham Radio Now has gotten done, but not nearly as much as I like. So that's the optimist part. I look at that week and think about how much I'm going to get done. It's the definition of crazy. I do that over and over again, and I keep expecting to be able to get more stuff done than is reasonable, based on history, based on just year after year of observing that behavior. Oh well, here's my route to Austin. Good old Google Maps. We're going to start out here in Cary, North Carolina, Interstate 40 down to Charlotte. This is the little detour to the Shelby Hamfest. And while I show it on the map, I'll actually be departing on Sunday from Charlotte. Shelby is open on Sunday, but I'm not going to stop by there on Sunday. I'll just keep on trucking down the road. Going to go through Atlanta. A lot of D-Star activity in Atlanta. Expect to talk to a bunch of people on D-Star down there if I can get the radios all programmed up. This is a little detour that Arnie, one of the show's favorite fans and frequent, should I call him a critic? Not really a critic, an idea contributor. He's always got something that he wants to tell me about just about every episode. And I welcome that, Arnie and everybody else. Anyway, this, what button do I want to push here? That one? No. That one? No. That one? No. 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 There. That one. This is something Arnie suggested. This is MFJ. And he wanted me to stop and visit MFJ and do a tour there or something. And I won't be able to do that. I just don't have time to take a day out of the schedule in the trip, either on the way out or on the way back. So, plus MFJ has been so thoroughly covered by Amateur Logic. George and Tommy and those guys have, they've done tours of the factory and interviews with Martin Zhu and, you know, it's just, it's been done. So yes, I do something a little bit different. My interviews are different than everybody else's, different than what Tommy's would be and George. But I think they've got that pretty well covered. Plus, I don't have time. I may see if the guys in, well, here's the rest of the trip. And this trip is, by the way, the routing for this trip is based on something Arnie recommended. He said this is a really good route to take. It's not what Google says is the fastest. The fastest route would be going down here this way and through New Orleans, through Houston and on up, and there's the final destination. But this route will take me at least within radio range of Dallas. In fact, this is a little bypass that'll get me off the interstates. I may or may not take that bypass. I kind of want to go through Dallas. Sort of depends on what time of day it is, if I can miss rush hour. Because Dallas is the home of K5TIT, the first guys to put a D-Star repeater on the air in the U.S. outside of ICOM. And the folks that I visited when I was doing the digital voice for amateur radio program. No, I'm not going to bring the DVD in flying next to me. I don't have the production time for doing that. Anyway, I may go through there because it's, you know, sort of like the D-Star home in America. And then finally on the way down to Austin, Texas, and there we go. That's the Marriott where the digital communications conference will be. Let's look at a picture. What the heck? Big complex. All right. So look for something coming up on Ham Radio Now over the next few days, probably maybe Sunday, maybe Monday, something like that. As I'm on the road playing with the radios, I'm going to try to hook up the radio I've had sitting in a box. I don't know if you can see it in this shot, kind of through there, one of those boxes. Yeah, there it is. That's the Kenwood D710. I've had that for over a year, and I've never hooked it up. I'm going to see if I can squeeze in time to hook that up. I'm not going to mount it or anything, just kind of probably lie there on a seat and run as an APRS beacon. So look for KN4AQ-9 on APRS. If you don't have APRS yourself, the easy way to go do that is APRS.fi. Let me take a look at that. APRS.fi. It knows I'm here in Raleigh. And it's a good way to see the APRS activity in any place. You widen out and the map just fills up with stuff. You can see where, I think we've frozen it up. You can see where there's APRS activity, but suddenly it is frozen. Oh, I guess it had a lot of stuff to gather. I didn't realize I'd gone out quite that wide. Let's go back in, get things back under control. It keeps filling up with these little weather things, and you can turn those off. I think I'm not totally in control of APRS.fi because I just don't use it often enough to remember what I've done. In fact, I'm not even logged in. So yeah, all my turn on and turn off stuff is not ready. You can log in and set preferences and stuff. Oh, there's a weather beacon from Jeff, AC4ZO. Let's see what's going on at Jeff's. It's 64.9 degrees. We got a cool morning. This has been a fairly cool summer. It hasn't even touched 100 here in this part of North Carolina anyway. But it's humid, 94%. And the wind is 0 miles per hour at 19 degrees. It's, you know, very still. This is early in the morning. So maybe watch for me on APRS.fi or any other APRS that you've got. You can see the track. It's been a long time since I've run APRS in the car. What else? I guess that's it. I'll run this through the editor and stick it on YouTube. I probably won't even build a web page for it. And see you down the road. And for those of you that are making it to the DCC, I'll see you in Austin. Over and out.